Hello, I'm Jake DeMeo, and this is your GLTV News Brief, Friday, May 17th. On Saturday, May 11th, my sister Emma DeMeo and the rest of the class of 2019 have officially graduated from High Point University in High Point, North Carolina. Many of these graduates will be starting their next chapter of their lives with the education they have learned from college. In March, both states seem to be days away from changing their laws, but recently a push to legalize recreational marijuana in New York and New Jersey appears to be all but dead in both states. For months, the two states were locked in a race to legalize, vying for millions in tax revenue and progressive bragging rights. But at the end of March, the campaign in New Jersey abruptly collapsed, hours before a vote was supposed to be taking place. Governor Livingston High School's 2019 American Cancer Society Relay for Life is just around the corner. The cadets of the Berkeley Heights Volunteer Rescue Squad are raising money for this important cause by hosting their annual plant sale on Sunday, May 19th, from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. at the Rescue Squad building on 378 Snyder Ave. There will be a wide array of flowers to purchase. In addition, the cadets will be selling delicious baked goods, including brownies, cookies, and cupcakes. Leah's lemonade stand will also be joining the fundraising efforts. Leah will provide her famous lemonade and other homemade treats. The cadets would like to thank Hall's Garden Center and florists for providing the beautiful array of flowers for the event. Last week, Governor Livingston's softball team broke a 4-4 tie in the top of the fifth inning with 5 runs, followed by 4 more in the sixth against Oak Knoll. Evan Polita went 3-for-4 with 2 RBI in the win. Her teammate Julian Lopes and Gabrielle Lombardi both managed 2 RBI each. Julia McConaughey went 3-for-4 with a home run and 4 RBI while pitching a 6-hitter with 6 strikeouts. 4 runs and 1 walk for Governor Livingston in its 13-4 victory against Oak Knoll in Summit. For the last 2 weeks, GL students have been taking end-of-the-year AP exams that they have been preparing for. It is now then of those 2 weeks, and all students have survived their exams. The IMC will now be reopened for the rest of GL students to use, and our very own Mr. Voorhees will be getting his TV studio back. James Paxson said he was pleasantly surprised when he woke up Wednesday, and that's good news for the Yankees. The left-hander experienced no added soreness or stiffness following Tuesday's bullpen session. Keeping him on pace as he works his way back from his knee injury that knocked him out of his May 3rd start after just 3 innings and onto the injury list. Paxson, who is 3-2 with a 3.11 this season after coming from the Mariners in an off-season trade, said he has an MCL injury. Paxson, who admitted to some discomfort during Tuesday's session, is wearing a brace on his left knee to support the tendon and will continue to wear it even after he returns. Seniors, prom is quickly approaching. Be sure to hand in your permission slips to Mr. Kuroga and hand in your photo package information and your forms to leave early on prom day to Ms. Gillick. An email was sent to your inbox regarding prom tables as well. Submit the attached Google form to reserve seats with your friends. I'm Jake DeMeo, this has been your GLTV News Brief. Have a great weekend, GL.